The city was fathomless, like an ocean that no line could plumb. No matter how closely she examined its surface, there would always be unexplored regions in its far corners, neighborhoods unknown, overlooked, and nearly forgotten. That night she drove through the electric wild, where soft flares danced before her eyes as she scanned the landscape. The scene was punctuated by pangs of geometric longing, the formal notion of some mass desire. Sirens roared out into the dark fringes. The buildings on the horizon were stark and black. It was a metropolis of some other order, whose true construction was not glass and steel, but fear. In the days to come, there would be no one to speak of the universes that were formed and vanished here. The night enclosed her in a cold embrace. There were no stars, only screens that flickered through the windows of enormous apartment blocks. She knew it was close. She could feel its silent hum as she began to dream. There exists but the thousands of mirrors that reflect her. With every acquaintance she makes, the population of phantoms resembling her increases. Awash in the LCD waters, she craved in anger. Something that had definitely happened at a definite time in a definite place. Nothing real could be inscribed on these liquid surfaces. Alone, she stood witness to the uttermost edge of the world. Superstition would inevitably drag her down, like rain eroding the deeds of her life. It would all dissolve into the vapor that rose from the sewers, into the smooth dark of this world. It was impossible for her to imagine a more perfect order. And yet on the other side of her calm, there lurked a fear of it spinning out of control. She imagined if the future existed, concretely and individually, as something that could be discerned by a better brain, people wouldn't find the past as seductive. Its demands would be balanced by those of the future.